All right, Frankie losing his shit. When I first found out that was going to happen, I was kind of not sure if that's something that should happen at CTWE, but the way it came off, man, it turned into something that was very special. I always kind of like somebody who kind of takes things and goes a little bit past the line and blurs the lines and stuff a little bit. And Frankie, I think, accomplished that with his promo. One thing, though, that is most memorable for that whole thing is the Vlad's Inside You chants, or the Vlad's Inside Us or something, because what he says is, he says, you guys have accepted Vlad into yourselves, or all of you have accepted Vlad into yourselves. And I was just, like, the fans just started chanting, Vlad's Inside You, or something like that. It was just hilarious to me. But other than that, just really awesome spot. I moved a very long distance with the goal in mind that I was going to help take CTWE to the next level. And that was never by way of my wrestling, because I couldn't do it with my wrestling, but with production and stuff, I knew that there was things I could offer that either Joey hasn't thought about yet or hasn't really seen a way to put it together. And I always tried to, that's what I wanted to do when I moved back, and we accomplished that and then some. Joey did everything he could to make sure that the fans were pleased every week or every month, and kudos to him, man. He deserves all the credit in the world, and I'm proud of him for closing the company down on his own terms instead of being forced to because maybe his dad stopped giving him money or something. So it's just really kind of cool to see how CTWE has grown from the first day I walked into the place and refused to take money from Joey because, like, it was just cool to be on the show, to where we're at now, where I just beg Joey to pay me for something. People know. Joey and I weren't actually really friends at this point. We've talked a little bit on Facebook, hung out a couple times for pay-per-views at Hooters, but at this point we weren't really friends, and I like to think that the Ram Jam is kind of what solidified our friendship, because it's when we realized we had similar senses of humor. I kind of went up to him while we were trying to build the ring up, and I was kind of like following him around as he's like wrenching the turnbuckles, and I was like, Joe, I think it'd be funny if I did the Ram Jam for the finish. And I thought he was gonna shit on it, but he said, yeah, do it, you know? And I was like, all right. So I just remember going up there and having my elbows up, and like I started really crying because like I was trying to emulate the final scene of The Wrestler. So like I'm fake crying, and it's like kind of really starting to come out, and I'm getting all emotional. And if you watch the video, man, it was just beautiful. It was so graceful. It was hilarious. But the best part about it is once I hit it, if you look in the windows, like where the bar area is, like on the tape, you see the fans, and then there's a wall, windows, and you could see a bunch of workers in those windows. Very dark, but you could tell they're workers. Look at their reaction upon impact. They go shit, like they're fucking bonkers. It was just really cool. I've never actually like gotten done with something and have a bunch of workers come up and say that was the fucking greatest thing ever. I don't get that often, so it was pretty cool to have that happen in the works for a year. And it was just kind of cool. One of my favorite things in that time period was thinking of ways to call Lucas and say, hey, it's not happening. Because Luke was so worried that this whole year that we had him set up to win the belt, finally at the following Brickomania, he was dead set that something was going to come up. So we kept calling him, being like, hey, Luke, Loki's coming back and he's winning the belt or something like that. It's just been really, it was really fun to mess with Luke a little bit. But then as time went on and it got closer and closer, I loved the buildup of it. The buildup was really kind of epic. The Rumble games, in fact, were created for Lucas. So I just think that's kind of cool. The thing that pissed me off, and it was one of the funny things about helping Joey run shows, is that I got to worry about the way CTWE comes across as a whole. And just the way that the fans started putting chairs on the floor, but then our own stupid-ass security guards were putting chairs on the floor. And if you watch the tape, you could see me run across the side of the ring to yell at security to be like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, you're supposed to be getting people away from the action and you're helping everybody put chairs on the floor. I just always thought that that kind of shit was the funny thing about helping with CTWE, is that we like had so many things right. But the one thing we couldn't get right is the security guards. And finally, with CTWE closing, I've never thought I was going to have the opportunity to be as successful as I was with CTWE, not not in the ring, but like helping Joey take things and make them as big as they got. And ultimately, like, some of my best friends I've made through CTWE, but at the same time, Nick D'Angelo, the commentator, was one of my best friends growing up, and knowing that his lifelong dream was to be involved in wrestling, and me being able to help him get that, knowing that he's a professional actor with voice work and stuff, doing commentary was perfect, and he's very knowledgeable about the product and the business in itself. So having him come and help, and helping him live a dream through my connections with CTWE, was very important to me. And without CTWE, I mean, life's changed because of it, let's be honest. And it's going to be sorely missed by everybody involved, I think. Now it's time for us to go home and shit. At least me. I got to go shit.